Well, here we have the rotor from an LM2500 with the blades from a CF6 airliner engine ready to be balanced. And I want to try to tell the story of how we got there. So we're going to have to back up a little bit, use some film clips from last week, and see what we can do. What we were specifically after was the high pressure turbine from the CF6. And actually, we were after the blades from the high pressure turbine, stage 1 and 2, because we didn't have any for the LM2500. So what we had to do was to take the fan off the front of the engine. The low pressure turbine off the back of the engine, and the shaft that goes through connecting the low pressure turbine to the fan, because the LPT drives the fan. Had to get all that off. We had to get all that off, and here's the LPT right there from the CF6. This is the drive shaft, or the power takeoff shaft. This is the shaft that drives the fan with about 25,000 horsepower, and it's pretty skookum. We had to cut through that with the grinder. Then we had to get the core out of the CF6. Now the core is the high pressure compressor, the combustors, and the high pressure turbine.
Slide, slide even more.
Yeah, back end is heavy. Yeah. Now the core is the high pressure compressor, the combustors, and the high pressure turbine. All of those things are virtually identical to an LM2500, and they are right here on the stand. We had to take the turbine out of the core, which we did. Okay. Approaching 2,000, 3,000.
Look at that blade.
Think of beauty. And we had to take the blades out of the turbine. The blades are here. This is the stage 2 blades. My gloves out of the way. Those are stage 2 blades from the CF6 airliner engine. They're going to be going into an LM2500. And you've just seen on the balance machine the blades from stage 1. Okay. Nice. Last one. Look at that. We're done. We got the first stage in. Now we gotta do the second.
LM2500 is coming together. Oh, there's a shop kitty sighting.
Now, of course, we had to use some specialized tools. There's a main coupling, it's not really a nut, it's a shaft inside the turbine that I can't show you because it's hidden, but it's driven by a spline, and what hooks onto that spline is a massive hydraulic torque wrench. This is the little one.
Here's the little one. And maybe you can see, it says, whoops, let's get out of the light there. Oh, there we go. It says, one division equals 1,000 inch pounds. Goes up to 120,000 inch pounds. Okay.
120,000 inch pounds is 10,000 foot pounds. Is that right? Yes, 10,000 foot pounds. That's the little guy. Okay, the one we had to use to break the torque on the main coupling on the CF6 airliner engine. It's got a coffee cup on it. It's right here. But that is a 30,000 foot-pound torque wrench. 30,000 foot-pounds. Now that sounds pretty impressive, doesn't it? But this thing, the output shaft, actually, let's go with the LM2500. The output shaft of the power turbine on the LM2500 has a continuous rating of 66,000 foot-pounds. That's while it's working. That's how it turns the shaft with that much torque. And a momentary peak loading capacity of 133,000 foot-pounds of torque. I just love saying that.
Okay, here is the PT, the power turbine from the 2500. And right there, you've seen this before. That shaft, that spline actually, drives a shaft with 66,000 foot-pounds of torque.
When people say, what are these industrial engines used for? Anywhere you need that much power. Moving a ship, generating electricity, or compressing and moving natural gas down a pipeline. So that's the story of how we got some turbine blades for our LM2500 out of an airliner engine. Some of the parts were a little bit abused and treated with great brutality. That's because they're not useful to us. The other ones that we were looking for have been treated with great care and been inspected into serviceable condition. Inspected to make sure they're in serviceable condition. Hope you enjoyed that story and stay tuned for more as we build up this engine from a variety of sources of parts. Thanks for watching.